So, Marilee, as someone who works with customers on a daily basis, what are some of the common questions you hear about our risk detections?
One common question from customers is, how do detections work for risk, and what is the difference between the different risk levels? Identity protection categorizes risk into three levels: low, medium, and high. These levels measure both the severity of the threat and our confidence in the detection being a true positive. Another frequent question is, what inputs are used to calculate those risk levels? We mainly look at detections from suspicious activities and vulnerabilities, and then assess their severity. Known leak credentials on the dark web would have a higher threat level assessment than, for example, an isolated instance of unfamiliar browser usage. We assess a variety of detections such as past user behavior, accounts with leaked credentials, MFA failure rates, workflow activities from the admin such as remediation and ignore, and explicit customer feedback. For both sign-in and user risk detections, a low risk level signifies that there are anomalies present in the sign-in or the credential, but we're less confident that these anomalies mean that the account is compromised. These anomalies may include unfamiliar sign-in properties such as IP, location, device, browser, or tenant IP subnet. Medium risk often includes a suspicious sending pattern or a combination of low-risk detections, such as more than one unfamiliar sign-in properties. High risk signifies high confidence that the account is compromised, including high threat signifiers such as leaked credentials or verified threat actor IP. Many detections can fire at one or more risk levels, depending on the severity of the anomalies detected. For example, unfamiliar sign-in properties might fire at high, medium, or low based on the confidence in the signals or the frequency of the signals. Now, listeners might be wondering, how exactly are these risks calculated? Dima, can you explain how we use machine learning to calculate risk and how risk detections work between real-time and offline and user and sign-in risk?
Of course, my pleasure. Our risk detections are split into several categories. Real-time detections are based on our machine learning models, which run during the time of the sign-in itself. That means that the sign-in is assessed as it happens and the risk level is calculated accordingly. If you have conditional access policies in place, then that sign-in can be blocked or remediated before it actually has the chance to succeed. Other than real-time detections, we have our offline detections. Offline detections are those that require processing of a larger volume of signals and thus take a longer processing time. These detections cannot occur during the sign-in, as we do not want the user to wait while we calculate the risk level. So we fire them after the sign-in is already completed, and as such, these detections affect the user risk directly, so that the next time the user attempts to sign in, it can be remediated, either via manual actions from the admin or by triggering a conditional access policy based on the risk level. In addition to the different types of risk detections, we also aggregate risk. Each user has an aggregate risk level, which is built from the combination of all different risk events, risk detections, and the sign-ins that the user has had. So basically, if a user has multiple sign-in detections for medium risk, it means that the user itself will be put at medium risk as an aggregation of those detections if they were not remediated during the sign-in by the policy. If they were remediated, then they will not be aggregated into the user risk as they are not risky anymore. All of these calculations are based on our advanced machine learning mechanisms, and they're mostly auto-generated based on the high-quality signals that we gather from the user properties, their behavior patterns, and from signals from our partner products within the Microsoft ecosystem, such as Defender. In addition to the machine learning-based detections, we also have our expert-generated detections, which are basically embodying the great work done by our security research teams who are responding to active attacks and are verifying the suspicious signals that we see, and are then triggering the detection to notify the customers that something might be risky. These detections are most likely to appear as high risk and are very high confidence.
Thanks for clarifying how the machine learning works under the hood. Microsoft is constantly analyzing and improving these detections. One concern we often get from customers, though, is that sometimes users or sign-ins are flagged as risky when they shouldn't be. To prevent false positives and ensure that legitimate users aren't flagged as risky, the best approach is to give the user the chance to self-remediate. Administrators can first use trusted locations to optionally mark IP-based locations, such as your organization's public network ranges. You can then configure conditional access policies to include or exclude these locations. Sign-ins from trusted locations will also improve the accuracy of Microsoft Entra ID risk calculation. Some signals may trigger more risk detections depending on the severity of the signal itself. For example, anomalous token risk is tuned to incur more noise than other detections to increase the likelihood of detecting replayed tokens that might otherwise go unnoticed. To determine the validity of a detection, we recommend investigating the sessions flagged by the detection in the context of other sign-ins and patterns from the user. If the location, application, IP address, user agent, or other characteristics are unexpected for the user, then the administrator should consider the detection. Dima, can you explain more about what admins can do to improve the accuracy of detections and provide feedback to Microsoft?
Thank you. I'd be happy to. In the past year, we've released a new capability, which means that the actions taken by the admin within the product are directly affecting our detection models and help improve the accuracy of future detections, both for the sign-ins and users. No matter the type of the detection, we have three actions available for you to take: confirm compromise, confirm safe, and dismiss risk. Each of those actions corresponds to the outcome you want to see from future detections. Confirm compromise basically means that this was a true positive. This confirms that the risk level is high and needs to be remediated, and teaches our model to continue looking for the same pattern going forward and continue triggering such detections. Confirm safe is an action that you should take if you determine a detection is a false positive. Performing this action removes the risk associated with the detection, whether it's a sign-in or a user, and puts the model into learning mode to make sure that similar patterns in the future do not necessarily trigger the detection. And finally, dismiss means that this is most likely benign true positive. This may be caused by your own internal security teams doing some simulated attacks or testing the system. So by dismissing the detection, you acknowledge that it was risky and should be flagged in the future, but it's not something that demands immediate attention, and it's something that you're aware of happening and are okay with the risk of it. In general, any feedback you can provide us about our product and our detections, whether it's by performing actions or by submitting in-portal feedback, will greatly help us improve our product going forward, and we encourage you to do so. Thank you.
And don't forget to visit our blog at techcommunity.microsoft.com to see the latest updates. We are constantly releasing new detections and improvements.